Allow me to ask you another question. How many programs do you know still support Windows 2000? I don't know a lot. However, this antivirus still supports even as early as Windows 98. I'm not going to go into too much background because I couldn't find too much information about the history of ClamWin. However, it is based off of ClamAV, an antivirus engine first released in 2002 and is nowadays owned by Cisco. ClamWin is developed independently and is FOSS, otherwise known as free and open source software, and ClamAV is actually licensed under GPL 2.0. ClamWin is the only major solution that uses ClamAV that is still around, since Cisco discontinued their own in-house antivirus ImmuNet earlier this year. And while ImmuNet, at the time of its demise, only supported as early as Windows 7, ClamWin, though it hasn't really seen a big update since 2021, still supports as early as Windows 98. So, let's give it a shot. As you see here, I'm running this on Windows 2000, and I'm going to install it here. I don't have too much to say about setup. It's your average installation, even though it's in a installer wizard instead of like being like some other antiviruses that are more of like what you'd see with like say Avast or AVG or Malwarebytes these days. So let's get to the main interface. It's fairly simple. In the about screen, it tells us that it's protecting us from 8 million viruses. Wow. We have this preferences window, which features various different options. I don't necessarily need to show too much here because it's just system settings. It's not really anything too special. So how about we run a scan here? Well, I will give this some lenience here because we are talking about open source stuff and people did criticize it for not being the greatest out there. I do want to briefly cut in here and say that this banner does look kind of nice. It's animated, but unfortunately it isn't updating to every time it scans a specific file. It just is animated normally. But I then waited like 45 minutes and I got literally nowhere. It was still on the screen. Oh, and by the way, I tried this a few times and to no avail. It just got stuck loading the database. Well, time for a change of scenery. I'm gonna use Windows Vista for the remainder of this video. And to put it simply, I did a test virus scan on a CD that I put in a disk drive because I got a working disk drive in this thing finally. And it didn't take nearly as long to load the definitions. We also have no problematic files on this. So how about we go scan for problems on another set? I'm going to use the partition that doesn't have too many files for this, and it took a tad bit of time, but it didn't find any problems. The last scan that I want to do is using the memory. Oh. This thing found some false positives and it detected a Trojan, which I went to check in another antivirus and I got no problems detected from that antivirus, which that one in question being AVG. Yeah, I think I can safely say that ClamWin found a false positive. That was where I was going to end this video off. However, a sleep-deprived me that was just trying to take thumbnails found more stuff to cover. We have this quarantine viewer for things that would likely have been put in quarantine. You can't add things to here, I don't think. And for the main antivirus, that's basically it. I wouldn't say it's too bad, but I wouldn't say it's the best. I mean, if you need something for an older version of Windows, like say 98 or 2000, this is probably one of, if not your only modern, still maintained antivirus options, and it'll probably protect you from like the main ones, as in the main pieces of malware that may be getting some form of attention from security companies. I don't really have too much to say about it. We can also uninstall it, which I'm gonna do because of the fact that I had to run System Restore on this computer. Well, that's gonna do it for this video. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next week. Bye.